This week, we're beginning a look at efforts outside the Capitol to address many of the same issues that are being debated inside of it. For example, job creation. NMIF producer Matt Grubs is here with how Central New Mexico Community College is training and retraining New Mexico's workforce.
Diane Burke, let's start big picture here. When we think of people retraining themselves in this economy, who's doing that? What are the faces you're seeing as you walk in the door?
I think there's a range. There are people in the health occupations that are looking to help build that industry here, and so they're going back for increasing skills as that industry changes. It could be medical records going electronic or equipment going digital, so that is one sector. We have a lot going on with industries that are coming in and trying to make their workforce more robust. Lowe's is coming in right now.
With a call center.
Mm-hmm. And they're doing some training at the Workforce Training Center at CNM. We've had a history of working with Intel and working with Eclipse and others who have done that kind of training. We also are doing a number of things in the green industry. We've worked with the fire departments around the state to do EMS training and help them get their certifications and their skill level up to speed across their workforce. So there's a range across a number of different industries and employers.
How do you find out who needs help? You mentioned some very specific things like with Intel and Eclipse, but then generally responding to things like growing job sectors. How do you sort of identify those?
A couple of ways. One is I think we work closely with other economic development partners in the community. So it could be the Albuquerque Economic Development, Rio Rancho Economic Development, the Chambers of Commerce of Albuquerque and Rio Rancho. We have advisory boards for a lot of our programs so that we're working with the smaller businesses and they're helping us understand what the trends are, what's changing in equipment or protocol in their industries. And then we reach out. We actually have business development managers who go out and call on businesses and help work with them about what are their needs and what are the kinds of things they're trying to address with their workforce.
So as we look at what's going on up in Santa Fe, there's a lot of talk about structuring our tax code so that we can bring businesses mm-hmm. here. There's also an effort by Senator Tim Keller to try to credit businesses for hiring graduate or advanced degree students from some of the four-year programs. This is a different way of mm-hmm. addressing a lot of that. As businesses come here, do they look at how ready our workforce is and how do they identify that?
That's probably the number one thing that companies that are coming here are interested in is what kind of workforce do you have here? And how ready are they to help them build that business that they're coming into to ramp? So in conversations that I've had whenever we're invited to a site selection team where we're being asked, how can you help this particular company? And they'll be identifying with the kinds of jobs they have or the kinds of skills they're looking for. In some cases, we are absolutely ready because it's something we do. And in some cases, we partner with them to develop curriculum that will help support the kinds of workforce that they want to build. But it is the number one thing that companies coming in are looking for. I think the place that community colleges play that may be different than tax credits for hiring university students
sure.
is we play in the middle skills. So those things that are technicians or they're electronics technicians or plumbers, welders, office workers, healthcare workers, security. So it's a middle skills level that we're particularly good at, I think, as community colleges.
Some of the people coming out of there are not necessarily competing directly against these people who would be, you know, investing in an advanced degree, that sort of thing?
Yeah, I don't think most of our people were community college. It would be either certificates or associate degrees. We tend to be very applied, so we're not just teaching theory. All of our programs have labs, and they're actually having to learn how to do something. A lot of our programs have industry credentials that are part of the degree, as opposed to a lot more of the four-year education. It's a very applied, focused
okay.
kind of training and education.
Sure, and one of the ways that's most readily apparent is this Green Jobs program.
Mm-hmm.
You have a grant from the federal government administered by the state government.
That's true.
But then they come to you, and what are they asking you to do?
It's a U.S. Department of Labor grant. that is being administered by the New Mexico Department of Workforce Solutions. They came to the community colleges and asked to partner with us. Three community colleges had been doing green curriculum and green industry training for a few years now. The solar expertise, if you will, was at Central New Mexico Community College. We were doing photovoltaic installation and also solar thermal, solar heating.
Okay.
Mesa Lands Community College in Tucumcari was doing wind, because that's their abundant natural resource out there.
Plenty of it.
And Santa Fe Community College had two things that they were up to. They were doing biofuels, alternative fuels, and they were doing green build energy efficiency. So they asked us all to take our expertise and to do three things with it. One is to develop curriculum further that's industry facing and share with each other around the state. So it wouldn't be just Albuquerque training in solar, but we would train around the state. So we'll go to Mesa Lands, and we'll go to Santa Fe, and we'll go to Doña Ana. So that's the workforce around the state has the same competencies and the same skill level.
Okay.
So that was one part. The second part was that we would share curriculum and we would share our partners so that the industry, no matter where they were located, would have the same access to workforce.
So some company that is based in Albuquerque wouldn't necessarily have an advantage because they can just hire the CNM solar grads.
That's
if they're
right.
out in Tucumcari or someplace in the east, they can hire from Mesa Lands too.
That's right.
Okay.
So Santa Fe will be teaching here in Albuquerque at CNM. We will go to Santa Fe and teach there. We'll go to Doña Ana in Las Cruces and teach there. We'll go out to Tucumcari so that all of the businesses in the state have an equal chance of getting the workforce that they need with the same competencies and skills.
Does that happen on a regular basis in other programs, or is this kind of
new? No, this is a new.
Okay.
This is a new collaboration for us. We've talked with each other before. We've kind of collegially shared, but we've never had a strategic plan to actually target the whole workforce around the state and all of the partners in the industry and give them all the same access to a trained workforce.
Okay, okay. And I kind of jumped in before the third part of your program. So they've asked you to share, but the third part?
So the third part is actually having this available to people who might not be able to be have access to it. So since it's supported by the grant, all of the training is free. All of the credentialing at the end is free, meaning if you take an industry certification, that's all part of the curriculum here. So that when you are going into the workforce, you not only have the training, but whatever credentials that you might have needed in the industry
okay.
that are green energy credentials, if you will. And we're also helping them get placed in jobs. So it's kind of a whole package of getting people either back to work who are currently unemployed, or they might have been contractors and have hard hit by the reception, or they are those who are working but really want to be more competitive in the workplace and want to get some more skill in renewable energy.
Sure. Are these jobs that are out there right now? I know sometimes the concern is, well, you're training these folks for a 21st century job market and or with 21st century skills, and the job market is a 20th century job market. Have we made that transition? Is it kind of a chicken and the egg thing?
A little bit of both.
Yeah.
I think New Mexico has incredible resources in renewable energy. We are 10th in installations. We have lots of wind and sun. Companies have been installing a lot of commercial let's say photovoltaic, a lot of commercial fields and installations around the state in renewable energy. We have right here in Albuquerque and in other places in the state manufacturers of solar. So I think that's a growing industry. Within the grant, part of it was partnering with the industry. And so we have partnered, I can talk more about the solar because that's where CNM is,
sure.
With Sacred Power, with Affordable Solar, with 310 Solar, all companies that are here in Albuquerque. We also have a partnership with the New Mexico Green Chamber of Commerce, which is across the state, and they have about 1,100 companies. So we are trying to get all of us working together at the same table, going in the same direction.
On the state level, there was, at least for a little while, a subsidy attached to solar power or solar energy generation. And I know the solar industry has said, we don't think we need that much longer. Is this sort of part of the reason why that they're going to be getting more qualified workers so that their work base is much broader, and they can bring these people in and ramp up their economies of scale a little bit faster?
I think there's a lot of truth to that. I think early on there wasn't the skilled workforce, and so the costs of doing business were high. I think more and more, first with some of the work we were doing before the grant and now with an actual plan that takes this statewide, that their cost of doing business is being met in other ways. And there's also a lot, if you listen to the State of the State the other night, there's also a lot of commitment nationwide to doing renewable energy. And I think that helps everyone feel a little more comfortable that this is a bet we're going to keep placing. And so we should continue to grow the workforce, and we should continue to expand these industries.
Sure, sure. We heard the president in the State of the Union talk about, you said community college.
Sorry,
that's okay. So retraining, about renewable energy, all sorts of things that are right in line with this program. You talked about contractors who've been hit hard by the recession. The faces of the people who are in these training programs, do you know who's going to be taking them? Have you seen them start yet?
The participants?
Solar, exactly.
We actually had a kickoff on Saturday.
Okay.
Here in Albuquerque, there were a few hundred people. We had all of the colleges come and talk. CNM was the host, and so we talked about our solar expertise. Mesa Lands talked about wind, and we had Santa Fe talk about biofuels and energy efficiency green build. Mm-hmm. We had people there to help them do pre-applications in terms of what kind of background, because some people are starting new and they need a level of training that's a little bit longer, and some are already in the industries. For instance, if you are already an electrician, mm-hmm. But you know nothing about photovoltaic installation, then you've already got the basic theory down and the OSHA material down, and we'll just be teaching you the more advanced photovoltaic skills. But if you're somebody who is unemployed and you're going to need electrical theory and safety as well, then it'll be a little bit longer, but we're doing both tracks. We just need to know more from the applicants about where they are in their skill level and their aspirations. But it was very exciting. We had, as I said, a couple hundred people there. The businesses were there. The
Sure.
Green Chamber was there. So applicants had a chance to talk to everybody and sort out. Kind of the exciting part, but made us a little nervous, is everyone goes, this all sounds so interesting. I want to do it all. And we were trying to get people to really look at what's a fit for their skills and the industries that they want to go in, because we do want it to be about employment.
As you look at the applicants, what age range are we seeing?
They were all over.
Really?
Yeah. It was, there were some people who you would really call this retraining. Mm-hmm. They've been out working and have either been laid off or they're not working at the level that they want to work at, or
30s,
family sustaining.
40s, 50s, that kind of age?
A lot of 40s and 50s.
Okay.
And then you had a younger, maybe 20s and 30s group,
sure.
that are really excited about renewable energy and want to be part of an emerging industry, or they were really excited about biofuels and what that might mean. So they're starting their careers, but they're looking at this as something that'll have a longer term career for them, in that it's an emerging field and it's not something what you alluded to before, that the 20th century skills versus the 21st. So some people were there really wanting to be involved in the 21st century.
Is there a number of jobs that you have set as a goal, or is it just kind of as many as possible?
Well, as many as possible is always the answer. But what the commitment is from CNM this year, and each college has their own, is to train at least 150 participants and to make sure that that a large part of them are employed. Whenever you start training, you know, everyone has to kind of shake themselves out.
Sure.
But I think we're going to more than meet our goals. I think the interest, I think the need in terms of both retraining and people needing employment, and I think the partnerships are really going to help make this a success.
Diane Burke, thanks so much for your time.
Oh, you're welcome. Thank you.